Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel, or if you're new here, welcome to my channel. My name is Sabrina, and today's video is not something that I would normally put up on my channel, but I want to use my platform and I want to use my voice to share my story, because this story is not one-off. I'm not the only person that this has happened to, and I know that because I've reached out to other wheelchair users, and I'm not alone, and this is unacceptable 100%. I have filmed this multiple times trying to give you guys the whole story, and I'm going to try to give you a rundown version of it because you need to know the background story for this all to make sense. And I apologize, my cat's going to be in the background. He's meowing. I have the door shut and he wants to get in. He's fine. He just wants to be near me at all times. So the background story for this is my sister got married in Jacksonville, Florida on November 15th, 2019. We flew down there, and because we flew down there, we didn't have any vehicles to get around in. My sister left immediately after her wedding to get on a cruise ship, and my mom, who drove us to the hotel, was leaving to go to Gatlinburg, Tennessee for her vacation. So it was just Jacob and I in the hotel without any rides to go. We'd already had a previously bad experience with Lyft on the 15th whenever we decided to go out for dinner. I'm not even going to get into that because it's not even, it was just a sketchy thing. The guy tried canceling our ride in the middle of our thing and it was really scary. So that put a sour taste in my mouth. After we got done eating though and shopping around, we called for a Lyft. We had three different drivers, one of them that drove to us, and I had forgotten to put like wheelchair user in the little notes thing. As soon as I put wheelchair user in the notes, he canceled within like 3 minutes. So then I automatically get selected with a new driver who, as soon as I get selected with them, I put wheelchair user in the notes section just so that they're aware. He calls me immediately and says, hey, you're too far away. Can you please cancel? He said that he couldn't cancel. And at that point, I was just frustrated. So I canceled it. I got matched with another driver whose name was Eduardo. He was amazing, super kind, super patient, and super helpful in the best way that he could be. Amazing guy. If all Lyft drivers were like that, then we wouldn't be having situations like this. We get to the hotel that night, we go to sleep, we wake up the next day, and we're needing a ride from the hotel to the airport, which is about 2 miles. We were told originally that we could get a shuttle, but that didn't end up working out. So at this point, we were using my account before we were using Jacob's account, and I had put on my Lyft account that I needed a wheelchair accessible vehicle. And wheelchair accessible for me, if you guys do not know, I am paralyzed from a spinal cord injury. My level's T12, so I'm very independent. I can transfer in and out. I can break my chair down if need be, but I had Jacob there, so the driver, whoever picked us up, literally just had to drive us to where we were going. The hotel that we were staying at was a microtel, and whenever we would book a Lyft, it would say that we were at the DoubleTree. So we matched with this one guy, and immediately I tried calling him to say, hey, I'm not at the DoubleTree, I'm actually at the microtel hotel. He didn't answer, and the app had told me like, hey, your driver, we're gonna call him driver A. A is in the middle of a ride, he'll be with you shortly. And it said it was like seven minutes away. And I can see him getting closer and closer to, I'm assuming he's driving toward us. He's kind of going like around, but the way that the road works, it was kind of like a round thing. And so I'm calling him. I called him a total of 5 or 6 times by the end of this, and he wasn't answering. So I thought, okay, maybe he's driving or whatever. So I sent him a text and I'm like, hey, I just want to let you know, it says that I'm at the DoubleTree, but I'm actually at the microtel hotel. Nothing. It sends like an automated message back. So then it says, hey, your driver A has arrived at your destination. I'm like, he's not here. And so I'm like, hey, like I'm in a wheelchair, and he makes his wait about 15 minutes and then can't. So I'm frustrated at this point. So I keep trying to book different lifts, different rides. Every time I get matched with a vehicle that is too high up, it's like a truck or something. And so I have to keep canceling those. Every time I cancel, it puts a pending charge on my account. Even though those pending charges are going to fall off, they still haven't, mind you. It's been a week, almost a week later. I'm still getting charged. So at this point, I've been charged like $30 for a ride that I'm not even getting. After that one guy, I just got so frustrated because every time I would match with a new driver, I would put in the notes section that I was a wheelchair user, and immediately they would cancel. Or immediately, or within like 3 minutes of seeing that, they would cancel. It was like as soon as they opened it, they would cancel. And it was obvious that they were canceling on me because I was in a chair, which is totally unacceptable. And not to mention, I had put on the app that I was needing a wheelchair accessible car. So I write out to Lyft and I'm like, hey, like, can someone message me because I'm being charged for these rides that I'm not getting, and this is very frustrating. So basically I send all the screenshots and I let the people on the social media team know what's going on. They're like, we understand how frustrating it is, but just so you know, someone from our social media team is from Jacksonville, so they can help you around the area. And I'm like, I'm leaving Jacksonville. I don't even know why you said that. So that kind of put a sour taste in my mouth. So then they get into my account and they're like, hey, we want to say that we noticed that you put wheelchair user in the pickup note, which can be very helpful. Just to clarify, do you have a collapsible wheelchair? If not, it says we may be able, a wheelchair accessible vehicle may be the best option, which I had selected. And then this is where I start to get real pissed. Their solution to not being, for their drivers canceling on me the moment that they knew that I was in a wheelchair, was to take another service. I'm not exaggerating, you guys. They sent me links to other places that, like taxis and transits and stuff like that, because they didn't want to deal with the issue. And I'm like, your solution is to use another service. We chose Uber and the first driver was able to accommodate us with zero issues. I even added wheelchair accessible on my account and still got matched with vehicles that were too high for me to transfer into. That's how I got driver A matched with, and clearly he couldn't hang because he canceled on me. And then they're asking again if my wheelchair is accessible, because I need to know if I can ride into it or if I can transfer in, which I can. And then they tell me that wheelchair accessibility is not available in Jackson yet. Jackson is a huge city. It's not a small town like what I live in. Jackson is a huge city, and for them to offer an accessible option but not have it in big cities like that is kind of a slap in the face. Not to mention, I didn't even need a van to roll into. I needed a car that was low enough and for a driver to not cancel on me the moment they knew that I was in a wheelchair. That was my issue. That's why I was frustrated. So then, instead of offering a solution again, because they're done with me, they send me a link to their wheelchair policy, which none of their drivers followed, which is why I was upset in the first freaking place. So I'm like, you're not being helpful. What I'm saying is, none of your drivers followed your policy. None of them. I will be calling corporate. This is a joke and you're not being helpful. After a while, they message back to me just some garbage, and they just keep sending me like crap. Basically, Lyft sucks. So now I'm frustrated. I'm at the airport. I'm trying to get all this stuff figured out, and I call them. I got tossed around to three different reps who still have not solved my solution. They just keep passing me off and telling me that their solutions are to take other taxi services or to other rideshare services. I forgot to mention this in my video, but when I was speaking to one of the service people on the phone, he told me that I could pay more for a bigger car and better service in order to accommodate for my wheelchair, which means he expected me to pay more money for the standard service that a regular able-bodied person would get. And that's not fair. That's not fair at all. So this is my PSA. Lyft does not give a fuck about you if you were disabled. They do not want to take you places. We had a wonderful experience with Uber. I talked to my other friend Veronica, who travels a lot. She uses Uber and has no issues. Like I said in the beginning of this video, this is not a one-off situation. I have talked to multiple people, and Uber is not squeaky clean either. Uber's had their fair share of that. But the one situation that I know about that someone tagged me in, the driver was investigated and he was fired because he canceled on a woman who had a service dog. Literally, Lyft was like, hey, sorry, we don't have that option. Try taking a taxi. And that is a huge slap in my face. You don't understand how frustrating it is to try to travel and explore the world and for nothing to work out because you're in a chair. Literally, those people were canceling on me strictly because I put in the notes that I was a wheelchair user, and that is not acceptable. And we need to stand up and say that this is not acceptable. Like, I don't want to give Lyft my money. I really don't. But there may be people who Lyft is their only option and they're in a wheelchair and they don't have anywhere else to go. And they need places like Lyft to take them to and from doctor's appointments or to and from jobs or whatever the case may be. Like, I, as a disabled people, like, disabled people are people too. We're human. And it is not acceptable for these people to just pass us off like we're nothing. That's what frustrates me the most. And they still didn't care. I talked to multiple employees at Lyft and nobody gave a single flying fuck about me. They just said, use a taxi, use another rideshare service. And how is that acceptable? It is not at all. I know that not everyone who follows me is disabled, but I hope that if you're watching this and you're not disabled, thank you so much for taking time out of your day. I hope that you will use your voice as an able-bodied person, and even as a disabled people, use your voice to make sure that this is known. Please do not use Lyft, because this is, like I said, it's not the one-off situation. They do not give a fuck about us, and that is a huge slap in our face. So I'm sorry I got a little heated at the end of this, but I'm feeling all those feels that I felt again in that moment. It is so dehumanizing to know that someone automatically places judgment on you because you're in a wheelchair. And I even tried giving them the benefit of the doubt, but Jacob, my partner, he is the nicest, most patient, most understanding person in the world, and he was pissed off because he saw it. He saw it firsthand, the shit that they were doing and how they just kept tossing me around because they didn't want to deal with me, and that is not fair. And I'm fortunate enough that I don't deal with this kind of crap every single day, and I have a choice to choose Uber, and I have a choice to not give my money to Lyft, but there are some people out there who don't have that option, and that's why I wanted to make this video, because it's not acceptable. So Lyft, if you're watching this, I hope that you do better, and I hope that you make changes. I hope that you do better to prove to us that you give a fuck about us.